Sommermärchen.
Introducing the all-new Corolla.
Well, I'm surprised because whenever they make payments of any sizable amount, there's at least a dozen press releases trumpeting the payment. But there was absolutely nothing on when and who was paid.
DOA Director Benita Manglotnia has confirmed that owners of the Ledzon landfill property have been paid by Gov Guam as per a court order through tax credits, but neither she nor the Department of Revenue Tax can confirm who was paid and how much they were paid because of tax privacy laws.
This is a bill, we got to pay it. Why not pay it this way?
Well, there are also thousands of landowners that have property that was taken for roads, routing all along Route 4 to down to Maleso.
The governor's spokesman, Phil Leon Guerrero, says these payments had to be made somehow, especially since some Ledzon landowners have threatened to take their property back.
The fact of the matter is that we don't have the cash to make these payments. A lot of the landowners have been talking about other options should the government not start paying this obligation to them, including taking the land that is currently being used at the Ledzon landfill back.
If you thought this was a good idea, why didn't you publicize it in a press release like you've done everything else?
All senators should know that there's a judgment against the government of Guam. All senators should know that this judgment needs to be paid. And all senators know that every day we don't pay this judgment, the taxpayers are liable for thousands of more in interest.
Budget Chairman Senator Ben Pangilinan is concerned about how these tax credits will affect the budget.
When we approve a budget, we approve a budget based on the collections of tax obligations that the citizens owe and the companies owe the government of Guam. When you award a tax credit, you cut the amount of revenues that will be received by the government. Therefore, we have less money to pay our current year obligations because we already earmarked that money to pay the operating cost of the government for this fiscal year, which means we're deficit spending.
If Senator Pangilinan knew what deficit spending was, then we wouldn't have had a $300 million deficit that the governor had to fix in 2011.
Senator Pangilinan questions this move, particularly because the governor is related to some of the owners of the Ledzon landfill property. The owners of the Ledzon landfill property who need to be paid according to the land condemnation judgment include Calvo's Insurance Underwriters, Alfred and Diana Israel, Joaquin Areola, Henry Tsai, Douglas Cushney, Young Chul Kim, Lee and Joanne Holmes, Oxford Properties, Jones and Guerrero, and Valencia Investments. But Leon Guerrero maintains that this is the best way for Gov Guam to proceed, considering the interest that is accruing on this debt.
It is in the best interest of the people of Guam for us to settle this as quickly as possible so that we don't rack up continual debt and, you know, have to divert money, precious resources that could be used for other things like public schools, like tax refunds and like supporting the hospital.